Welcome to Bottom Dwellers, and this is Season 6 with Clermont in the French League One. Okay, it's the start of Season 6. Not much has changed in the last couple of seasons. Paris Saint-Germain are still top, and we're still making the top four. It's time to try and push on. We say this every year for the last few years, but we've got the Wonder Kids. Can we get up there and actually push for that title? Okay, we're just checking the budgets. We have £23.6 million left in the transfer budget. Our original budget was £21 million. You can see it's the 1st of September. The transfer window is done and dusted. We have a lot of money left. It would seem we haven't spent any, but there's a lot going on. All right, let's get into those transfers. Go to the transfer history. I have to go back to last year just to show you a couple of outs. It might seem a bit crazy, but at the end of the season, I actually sold Alban Lafont, an excellent, experienced goalkeeper. We sold him for $15 million. He had been good to us for three seasons. AS Monaco came knocking. I could not turn down their $15 million because we don't make any money. And we also sold Lucas Kutchevenda, also going for £15 million. Mets came, they wanted him. He was one of our best players, but I've moved him on. I think we can invest in our youth and actually have better players, even though he was 23 and a starter for us for many years so far. Going into this year, just checking the outs again, we have also sold a bunch of periphery players. Seca, Vernier, Kwatse, Serre, Diamande, and Karim Nemati for 4.7 at the end. That was a good piece of business. All right, on the ins, what have we done? We've obviously sold our goalkeeper, so we've brought one in. We'll get to him in a moment. First up, we've got Brandon Mulsa, a 19-year-old. We have brought him in on a free transfer. We got him from Paris Saint-Germain. He's one for the future. All right, Mas Juara, got him from FC Bayern, a 17-year-old. He looks out of control already at 17. Look at the attributes on him. His physicals need some work. He's got good value already. He can play in that midfield spot in the center. Here we go. Here is our new goalkeeper, Kim Christian Hoyenhall. We sold Lafont for 15. We bought in a goalkeeper for 6. This guy is the future. I think he might end up being the best goalkeeper in the world. He is 20 years old and he is banging in attributes already. He's 6'4", excellent jumping reach and agility. The aerial reach is great, handling, kicking, reflexes, positioning, concentration, and he's 20 and he's only going to get better. He is a 5-star potential ability already sitting there with and a massive 3.5-star current ability. 20 years old, Norwegian. I got the advice, get to Scandinavia. I took it and have really run with it. His value is crazy as well. Albert Villanueva, another one from Scandinavia, from Norway. Also out of control, midfield center. He looks great. He's going to start playing straight away. We picked him up for 4.2. Antonio Timane, this one's just a bit of a hit and hope. 18-year-old Mozambican, I saw him for not much money. His attributes looked okay, 110K, and we've loaned him straight back to his old club, see if he can develop into something. And the last one from Colo Colo is Diego Rios, a Chilean. He is a centre-back. He looks pretty good already. He's only 18. His value is great. He is a 5-star potential player. His heading is 17. His jumping reach is 18. He's 6'4". Great bravery. His mental attributes are pretty good for an 18-year-old. I can imagine he is going to slot into our first team very, very soon. So that's the ins. Have we done enough to improve our position in the league? Well, time will tell. All right, this is our team for the season going ahead. It is extremely young. Starting at goalkeeper, we've got our new man, Hoyenhall. On the right, Delich. On the left, Alvarez. In the center of defense, we have Denoyer and Hawks. Defensive midfield is Papula. Central midfield, Villanueva and Roberts. On the wings, we have Bocanegra and Mikesh. And our Tasman up the top, Blanc, our young, massive striker, leading us in the forward position. We've made a change to the tactic. I've actually changed the right back position to an inverted winger. Reason for that is I wanted De Ligt to play at the same time as Alvarez. They are both coming along beautifully. That means this inverted wing back will sit in around this central spot now and help out there. So to negate that and have some width on the right, I have made a winger in our attacking midfield spots. That's Bocanegra. So we still have that same width on the right, bit of width on the left as well from the back line. And we'll see how that goes with the tweak this year. All right, we're in three competitions this year. We are in the French Cup. They want us to reach the quarterfinal there. That's the board, of course. We are in the Euro Cup again. They want us to reach the second knockout round. Our group consists of Tottenham, Hoffenheim, and Ludo Goretz. I would expect us to really challenge for that second spot there. Tottenham are probably a little too strong. And obviously, we are in the League One Uber Eats. We have had an excellent start. We have managed to have four wins from four games, beating Lorient, Paris FC, not Saint-Germain, Marseille and Strasbourg to give us 12 points and a 7-goal difference to start the season, which is great. All right, let's see how we go with our very, very young team. I will see you at the end of the season, and hopefully, fingers crossed, we have won something. And here we are. It is the end of the season, and it is a bit of Groundhog Day. I can see already we have finished fourth once again, and that probably only puts us into the Euro Cup positions. An excellent 69 points with 30 goal difference. We are still around the mark and doing well, but not pushing ahead. And as I said, that is unfortunate. All right, let's check out the competitions page and see if anything else is happened. Oh, there we go. All right. That is completely unexpected. Not the trophy I was thinking we might win. But there we are. We have won the Euro Cup 2 after being knocked out of a pretty tough group in the Euro Cup. That is our first European trophy. There is tick number 1 for this bottom dweller's save. We have won something in Europe. We are just needing to win the league now. All right, let's go from right to left here. It is the French Cup, knocked out in the quarterfinals by Monaco. Let's come back to the Euro Cup 2. We got knocked out in the Euro Cup. It was a pretty strong group. Three teams that were decent. We finished third and got put into the Euro Cup 2. And of course, you have seen we came fourth in the league. All right, let's see how we went in the Euro Cup 2. We beat Frankfurt 1-0. That is fantastic. Let's check out how we went with this. We would have come into the first knockout round. Yep. And we won 9-0 against Osijek. That's pretty big. In the second knockout round, we took on Sigma Olomouc and won 4-0. We're playing awesome at this stage. Quarterfinals, we took on someone a little better. It was very close. We beat Galatasaray by 1 goal on the aggregate. The semi-final, that put us against Roma, and we smacked them off the pitch. 5-0 drubbing of Roma. That is a great one. I can't believe that. That took us to the final where we took on Eintracht Frankfurt and won 1-0 to win our first European trophy, which is fantastic. Going into the League One Uber Eats, let's check out how that went. We'll pull up that league table. All right, it is not looking great. Paris Saint-Germain have won it again. That is now, what, 5 times in a row for them? This is going to be tricky. Dembele from Lyon wins the goals. Doku with the best average rating. Maya with the assists. And Doku with the player of the match. And not sure if you can see it, but Donnarumma wins the clean sheets, as you would expect, being from Paris Saint-Germain there. Let's look at the stats for the players after a very successful season winning the Euro Cup 2. In the goals, we have Christophe Blanc, Villanueva with 14, Bocanegra and Mikesh coming in with 12. Blanc got 27 in all competitions. He has actually won the Under-21 World Footballer of the Year and the European Golden Boy. He is coming along beautifully. In the assists, we have Mikesh with 15, Roberts with 15, Villanueva with 10, Delich and Bocanegra with 9 and 8 apiece. And on the average ratings, we have many, many players playing beautifully. We have already highlighted Blanc. We'll have a look at René Denoyer, a centre-back. His attributes look to be coming along really well-rounded and nicely. The other centre-back, Adam Hawkes, playing well. He looks great. Big guy. Attributes in the right spots. Only 20. Also have a quick look at Mikesh, our winger, who's coming along very beautifully as well. I cannot speak much higher about all of these players. They are just super young, and we need them to develop even quicker if we're going to overthrow Paris Saint-Germain in the future. All right, it's going to be really exciting next season. I'm going to say it again. Hopefully we can push on up. We'll see you there in Season 7. That brings Season 6 to a close. Thank you very much for watching. You have witnessed us winning our first European trophy, even though it was in the lowly Euro Cup 2. The young team we have at Clermont is becoming world beaters, I think. They look like a great group of lads. Hopefully we can keep them together, fend off those teams, probably trying to buy all my new superstars and wonder kids, and really, really push, and finally, hopefully win that League One title, overthrowing Paris Saint-Germain. All right, thank you very much, and I will see you on the next episode. Bye.